Educational technology has got three requirements to fulfill when we talk about virtual teaching or e-learning, or we talk about teaching during the lockdown through any virtual teaching or e-learning mode. We need to share contents with them. They need to have a repository like available. The second thing will be we need to create interactive activities. Interaction platform can be there, the way we are interacting these days through chats and all these things. And the other thing that we can share is that we also need to have something which is called assessment. And the assessment has to be quite interesting. Assessment has to be something which entertains them and which engages them. So we are presenting to you, this is called Quizizz, Q-U-I-Z-I-Z-Z, Quizizz.com is a platform to play online games, and it is possible for us to create quizzes. We can use the quizzes created by others. You can create your own library, you can generate reports through it, and we are going to watch a presentation about the use of quizzes. First, we are going to just see, there is a quiz that we can see how it is being made. We are going to the quiz, like this is a quiz on grammar. 10 questions only, and this is how these questions will look like, and let's practice it just for a few seconds to see how it looks. This is quizzes, as you can see on the screen also. Suppose you can see these are the flashcards as well. So we have clicked on play again, and then it's opening. It's quite entertaining. It is animated. There are so many good features. Also there, and then such kind of images are also how it goes. And here we are with the presentation as well, and we'll see how Quizizz has been used. So Quizizz is an online platform. There's no application or software. It is possible for you and me and everyone to use it in the web browser. The smartphone application is also available, but you can create quizzes in the browser version only. So either you use your mobile phone or you use your desktop. So Quizizz is something you sign up. That's quite easy. You can log in with your Gmail also, or you can sign up. And after that, you see, you can search the quizzes by clicking on find a quiz, or you can join a game if someone has given you a code. So that way you can use it. And please remember that the score and the reports for the practice sessions are not generated, but otherwise all the scores and reports are generated for the games that you host. So we are moving on. You know how to find it. Now you can create a quiz. This is what you can do in the free account, and then you can develop some collections also. Pre-made quizzes by others can be saved by you in your library. That way we have got these collections of playlists in YouTube also. You can add memes, you can generate quiz reports, and you can email the quiz reports to the parents, to the students as well. So this is how. One more thing is there, when we mentioned find a quiz, it is possible for you to apply the filters like relevance, recent and the most played, grades and subjects and languages, a number of questions also. You can customize them. This is the interface that you can see. My quizzes, the quizzes that you make are saved there. Reports, you'll click and you'll find quite useful. You can see the games played, and you can generate an Excel sheet. The CSV file will be generated by you, and then you can share that with everyone. Classes means it can be integrated. It can be attached with the Google Classroom, and it is quite possible to use it in the Google Classroom as well. All your classes of the Google Classroom will be visible here. The collections in which you save, and the memes are also there. So we move on to create a quiz. We click on create a quiz, and then you give it a title first, and then you select the relevant subjects to which it relates to. Sometimes there are multiple subjects in which you feel it will fall. So this is what we do, and then these are the choices for you. These have been the common types of questions that we need, and this is what Quizizz provides: multiple choice, checkbox, fill in the blanks, polls, and open-ended. And there is a button called teleport. You will also see it. In the teleport, you can bring the questions which have been in the quizzes made by others. If you click on teleport, the title that you had given to your quiz, according to that title, it will search for the ready-made quizzes. You'll click on that quiz and you'll throw the questions in your basket. So this is the interface. You can see you can rename your quiz. You can set it to public and private. Private means you can send a link, and only those who have the link will play. It will not be available as a public property to everyone. Then we have got an image option also. You can add an image. And in the quiz, when you are putting questions, the statements can easily have an audio. You can record it there and then. and you can put a question statement in every, you say, question that you create. You can put an image also. So these are the things that you have in the desktop version. Please see that, add a question, and all these things will be available. Pre-made quizzes can also be used by you. So this is how we are going to make a quiz. Then you type the intended title, and then you, this is about teleport, so you click on teleport, and this is what you get. So you are moving on, you click on teleport, you type either the topic, or by default, if your title was appropriate, it will search. There'll be a button called add. You keep on clicking on add, and it will be throwing the questions to your basket. Then we prepare it and we click on save, and then we send it for practice. There are three options. You can play it live, when means you can host it live. You click on play live, then you have the option of team competition, you have got an option of individual participation, and you can host it as a class test also. So that way it will be happening. Live scoreboard will be available in the first two, like team and classic. In the test, of course, when we take a test, live scoring cannot be shown, because when they'll submit and then you have to release the result. You can assign it as a homework through Google Classroom, or you'll click on it and a code will appear, and that code or the link can be sent to the students. When you practice, they can only practice, no reports are being saved. There are two more options. One is share the quiz with the fellow teacher and instructors. If you click on the share button that you can see on the top, along with the copy icon that we can use to copy the quiz and then edit the copied one, you can click on share, and this link can be sent to other teachers for using this quiz. And then we have got a print. When you click on print, a beautiful ready-made, ready-to-use file PDF can be generated as if it is a quiz sheet. So this is how, when you click on play quiz, you see host a game, classic, team and test, and these features we have explained. That way you get a code, and this code is given, and then you use it on their, you can say, applications that they have on their mobile phones, or they have got joinmyquiz.com visited in the browser. You go and you enter, this is the browser interface, everyone. You go on Join My Quiz and you enter the code. This is how it happens. The student will be finding it this way, that when they enter the code, they'll be waiting for the game to be started. So there is a streak meter, there are redemption questions also. It is kind of a con banega, a crorepati, you can see. So these are the things. Time freeze is also there. Such power-ups will be given to the players when they answer things correctly. So these are the things, but there are few instructions that are required to be remembered. The teachers or the hosts desktop screen will be displaying the results, as you will see the results or the scoreboard is there. You can remove any player during the game if you feel they are not playing it well or there's some error by them. You can remove them and they can join again. So the top three winners will be displayed as if a virtual prize distribution will be happening. The reports can be sent to parents and can also be generated as a spreadsheet. So this is what happens. This is how the results are made. One is a team mode award ceremony. The moment you will click on close the quiz, and the quiz will be there on the right hand side when the quiz is running. So you will be getting this thing, and it will be displayed to everyone who is playing the game with you. And the reports page looks like that. You can generate it, you will see the accuracy, you will see the players also. You can click and you will see the reports. So Google Play Store and App Store have this application.